गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल एट योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल विज्ञान विहान। दिस इज अवर प्रॉब्लम सॉल्यूशन सीरीज फॉर जनरल एप्टीट्यूड पार्ट ए ऑफ यूजीसी सीएसआईआर नेट। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम नंबर 11 टू 15 ऑफ यूजीसी सीएसआईआर नेट फिजिकल साइंसेज एंड लाइफ साइंसेज पेपर जून 2019। दिस जनरल एप्टीट्यूड पार्ट इज इनेविटेबल पार्ट ऑफ दिस प्रेस्टिजियस एग्जाम। It is also scoring for candidates who are attempting these problems with accuracy and efficiency. So, keep practicing, keep in touch with us, keep watching this video till the end. Let's start the solution. Friends, here is the first problem of this episode. Problem number 11. 21 liters of water in a tank is to be divided into 3 equal parts using 5, 8 and 12 liter capacity cans. The minimum number of transfers needed to achieve this is. They are given 4 options. Option 1, 3, option 2, 4, option 3, 5, option 4, 7. We will have to find the correct answer from the given options. Friends, here is the data which is given in this problem, which is required to solve this problem. The 4 options which are given in the problem are here. Now, there are only 3 containers, which are 5 liter, second one is of 8 liter, third one is of 12 liters. Now, we have 21 liters of water. Now, we will have to divide it into 3 equal parts. That means, we will need it to be divided into 7 liter, 7 liter and 7 liter parts. Now at first we will have to confirm that all these 3 containers doesn't have any scale to measure the smaller quantity than its total quantity. We can only measure here 5 liters, here 8 liters, here 12 liters. Then there is no any container which can measure directly 7 liters of this water. Now, at first step, we will transfer 12 liters of water in this first container, that is of 12 liter. In this first step, the remaining quantity of water here would be 21 minus 12, that is 9. Here it is 0 liter, here it is 0 liter, but here it is 12 liter now. In the second step, we will transfer the 5 liters of water from this 12 liter container to 5 liter container. Then here is 9 liter in the main container. Here now it is 5 liter. The remaining quantity of water in this container is now 7 liter. Now we will transfer this quantity 7 liter of water to 8 liters container. Then in this step the condition would be like 5 liters here, 7 liters here, the remaining quantity is 0 liter here because this container is now empty. In the next step we will again fill up that 12 liter container, but in one step we will transfer this 5 liter to the 12 liter container, then it would be now empty again and 7 liter in this container and 5 liter to the 12 liter container. Now from this 9 liter container we will fill this 12 liter container, then the remaining quantity would be here 2 liter, 0 liter in this container, 7 liter in this 8 liter container and 12 liter to this 12 liter container. In the next step, we will transfer 5 liter of water from this container to 5 liters container. We will fill this container and get the condition like 5, 7, remaining quantity which is 7 and 2 liter is here. In the last step, we will transfer 5 liter of water to this external container, then get the condition for division of this total quantity 21 liter of water to equal 3 quantities 7, 7 and 7. we can count these steps, the minimum number of steps which are required to divide this quantity in equal 3 parts is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the correct answer of this problem is option 4, that is 7. Friends, here is the next problem, problem number 12. Of 4 agents alpha, beta, gamma and delta, 3 have to be sent together on a mission. If alpha and beta cannot go together, beta and gamma cannot go together, and gamma and delta cannot go together, then which of the following holds? Option 1, any 3 agents can be sent. Option 2, alpha, delta and anyone out of beta and gamma can be sent. Option 3, beta, gamma and anyone out of alpha and delta can be sent. Option 4, the mission is impossible. We will have to find the correct answer, which is a perfect conclusion from these given conditions. Friends, according to the given question, there are 4 agents which are alpha, beta, gamma and delta. According to the given condition, alpha, beta cannot go together, beta, gamma cannot go together, gamma, delta cannot go together. We can make a rectangle using its vertices as alpha, beta, gamma, delta. But according to the given question, for a mission, minimum 3 agents are needed. But if according to the given condition, alpha, beta cannot go together, beta, gamma cannot go together, gamma, delta cannot go together, in that condition, any 2 out of these 4 agents can go together as alpha, gamma, or they may be delta, beta. But out of the remaining 2 agents, anyone cannot go with them. If alpha, gamma will go together, then because alpha, beta cannot go together, so we cannot take beta as the third participant, and for gamma, delta cannot go together, so we cannot take the delta agent as the third partner. Similarly, if we take beta, delta as the 2 agents of this mission, because beta have taken here, so alpha cannot go together, so we cannot take alpha as the third participant, and for delta, we cannot take gamma as the third participant of the mission. In that condition, if minimum 3 agents are required, this mission is impossible. That is given in option 4. The correct answer of this problem is option 4. Mission is impossible. Friends, here is the next problem, problem number 13. An open rectangular box is made by excluding the 4 identical corners of a piece of paper as shown in the diagram and folding it along the dotted lines. Here is a given figure. We will have to find the capacity of the box in centimeter cube. There are given 4 options. Option 1, 8000. Option 2, 1000. Option 3, 4000. Option 4, 6000. Friends, here is the figure which is given in this problem. Here is a square shaped sheet of paper. We are making a tray excluding these parts which have 10 by 10 centimeter area on all 4 sides. Then the remaining part will make a tray. There the base side will be remaining length 20 centimeter, because total length here is 40 centimeter minus this excluded part 10 plus 10, that is 20 centimeter. So the base area of the tray will be calculated 20 centimeter, taking it as the side of the square base. So the side here is 20 centimeter. Now this remaining part which have length as 10 centimeter will be now the height of the tray. Then it has 10 centimeter height. Then this tray will have its volume as the base area multiply with height. Here base area is 20 by 20 because the area of a square is side square, so 20 square, 20 is given in centimeter and height is also 10 in centimeter. So the answer will be in centimeter. From the calculation we can get 4000 centimeter cube. The correct answer of this problem would be 4000 centimeter, which is option 3. Friends, here is the next problem, problem number 14. Which of the following is the largest? 2 power 50, 3 power 40, 4 power 30, 5 power 20. Option 1 is 2 power 50, option 2 is 3 power 40, option 3 is 4 power 30, option 4 is 5 power 20. Friends, here are 4 quantities which are given in this problem. We will have to find the largest quantity from these given values. We are going with the method by equating the powers of each quantity. Now we will convert these quantities in power of 10. Then 2 power 50 can be written as 2 power 5 whole power 10. Then it can be calculated as 32 power 10 because 2 power 5 is 32. Similarly, 3 power 40 can be written as 3 power 4 whole power 10. That can be written as 81 power 10. 4 power 30 can be written as 4 power 3 power 10. So it will give us the value 64 power 10. The final quantity 5 power 20 can be written as 5 power 2 whole power 10. That will give us the value 25 power 10. All the powers here are equal now. So we can easily compare these quantities by comparing their bases. Which one have the maximum value of base? Here it is 81 power 10, which is similar to 3 power 40. So it is the largest quantity from these given quantities, 3 power 40. So the correct answer of this problem is option 2, 3 power 40. Friends, here is the last problem of this episode, problem number 15. A monkey climbs a tree to eat fruits. The amount of energy gained from eating fruits and the energy spent in climbing on different branches have a relationship shown in the figure. The ratio of energy gained to energy spent will be maximum. We will have to find the appropriate answer from given four options. Option 1, at a point where the slope of the curve is maximum. Option 2, at a point where the slope of the curve is unity. Option 3, at a point on the curve where the tangent passes through the origin. Option 4, at the highest point on the curve. Friends, in this given problem, here is the curve which is given for energy spent and energy gain by the monkey during its climbing on the tree. Now, we will first define how the curve XY will work. If there is any curve between X and Y, where Y is function of X, we can write here at any point dy by dx as the differentiation, and this differentiation value can be calculated at that point by slope of the tangent at that point. So here is the formula which will give us the value of this ratio between y and x, that is given by tan theta, which is called slope of the curve. Now again we will revise this problem. In this problem, question is asking the ratio of energy gained to energy spent will be maximum at, energy gained is here, so it is y quantity, energy spent is here, it is x quantity. Y upon x can be calculated by the slope of the curve. So the ratio y upon x is maximum at these points where the slope of the curve is maximum. We can see here the slope of the curve is maximum in this initial part. So according to the given four options, the correct answer of this problem is option 1. The slope is maximum at these points where the slope of the curve is the maximum. Friends, keep practicing. You can download this paper from the Google Drive link given in the description. I wish you all the best for your results. Keep watching. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends. Please subscribe this channel and don't forget to tap on bell icon so that you can get notifications. Thank you.